Hey, welcome back. Welcome back. You're watching Liquid Lunch on Newsmax TV, kicking off a whopper of the hour two of a Woman Wednesday show. Now, right here in New York City, just around the corner, is the courthouse where the jurors in the Harvey Weinstein case are deliberating as we speak. There could be a verdict at any time. Frankie's covering that closely. Any news to report there, we'll bring it to you right away. And right here in studio, as usual, on Wednesday, I'm joined by super mom, model, actress, producer, and philanthropist, Zen Sims, who is always here with us on Woman Wednesday. Thank you for joining us again, my friend. So you've done it all, of course. You're a much accomplished woman in many places. But in the entertainment area, you're in film, and you're in movies, you produce movies. So this Weinstein stuff kind of hits home for you.
Yeah.
And you've been keeping us up to speed on this. The jury's deliberating. I have a source over there who tells me they've already sent the judge last night a note with like a four-part question, so the jury might be a little confused. What do you know?
Well, Donna Rotunno is a Rottweiler, and she's doing a great job. I mean, she has literally lost, what, one case? And maybe in a Chicago courtroom this plays out well, but interrogating women over 9 hours and making them feel like they're having these anxieties and breakdowns on the witness stand, I think was pushing it, especially for New York, where a lot of the jurors, the specifically five women and seven men, are very, very sensitive to the Me Too movement. But what I want to focus on is one particular model by the name of Ambra Gutierrez, who essentially was the whistleblower. Back in 2015, she walked into a Tribeca precinct. She had a crazy story about Harvey Weinstein groping her. They made her wear a wiretap. She proceeded to get him to confess that he did grope her and, you know, all of the
do
above.
Do all the things
right.
that he wasn't, or she alleged.
And at the time, Cyrus Vance Jr. denied to charge Harvey Weinstein, who is the Manhattan DA.
And it came out later on, Zen, that you know, Harvey Weinstein and his friends had made some significant donations to
absolutely,
Cyrus
absolutely.
Vance.
Even Martha Bashford, who was the former head of the sex crimes unit, who just resigned this month, made Ambra at the time feel like she was the criminal. She interrogated her. She made her feel like she was a prostitute. She asked her about what her objectives were with Harvey Weinstein after the wiretap caught Harvey Weinstein confessing to groping her breasts. So this story has gotten to be somewhat of an epic story, because the fact that they're still deliberating if this man is guilty or innocent is kind of mind-boggling. There's 100 women here who have a very different story. Ambra Gutierrez, who, her life got ruined over this. Ruined. She went into a depression. She gained 30 pounds. She's now coming out of the woodwork, and she's reasserting her position. And especially since those tapes, she signed a $1 million non-disclosure agreement to bury all allegations, because she was fearful of her family and her safety.
She wanted a million bucks.
Yeah. And in 2017, she broke her silence and she brought all this to surface. So it's really because of Ambra that this whole, you know, this case has been brought against Harvey Weinstein. But at the end of the day, I think we should
at least
give her some sort of praise, because Ambra did.
Well, it is tough to come forward.
Yeah,
we know that.
Absolutely.
I've had many,
so
you know, clinical psychologists and others who have said, you know, that's one of the most underreported crimes is sexual harassment and rape, because women feel victimized just telling someone else.
Right.
Now, I want to get your opinion. You're a fellow New Yorker, but you're well traveled. But Mike Bloomberg is now dove in headfirst into the race. And he's spent about $350 million so far. He's in second place nationwide. But this story keeps dogging him for the last 20 years, that people that worked for Bloomberg have sued him inside and out and attributed all kinds of claims. Now, one thing I talked about yesterday was a woman who had been working there for quite some time. And she had a baby, and she was coming back to work, but she was asking a supervisor for a little more time because...
See, Kiko Garrison.
Yes. And
1995.
And, you know, Bloomberg, I'm paraphrasing, but basically said, it's a baby. All it does is eat and blank.
He said kill it, is what he said.
First he said kill it.
Yeah.
Before it was born.
Yeah.
But then after it was born, he said, nah, the kid doesn't even know you. Don't worry about it. And it was like a double-barreled attack, because not only was he saying your kid doesn't matter, all it does is eat and poop. No, all you need to do is find, doesn't even know you. Don't. And then he said, all you need is some black who doesn't even speak English in case they're in a burning building. So, I mean, what is this going to do to him with women? I mean, there's a lot of this stuff out there.
He lost my vote. I mean, the one thing I have to say is real is rare. So for Mike Bloomberg to boast about everything that he's done for our economy, for women, for society, for me as a woman, is a big blow to the face. When I hear quotes like, if women wanted to walk past the construction site and doesn't get a whistle, we'll turn around and walk past again until she does get one. I'm sorry, Michael Bloomberg, that is absolutely disgusting.
That's what he thinks, that women just keep walking back and forth until somebody whistles at
him. Yeah.
Like to him, a self-respecting woman.
Mike Bloomberg, it's not self-respecting. And he has come out to say that he would not be where he is today without the support of women. Yet, over the last 20 years, 64 employees, 40 allegations. He has really, really shown us that he is not real at all. And he has absolutely lost my vote. And when this keeps resurfacing, the Washington Post is rerunning the story. There's excerpts from a catalog from an old employee that surfaced in 2001. And basically, it lists all the colorful remarks that
Michael Bloomberg's greatest hits.
Yeah, his greatest hits. That's what this this little pamphlet that has been featured with all of his remarks features. And it's quite disgusting to have a presidential candidate, 78 years old, who has a past like he does. $60 million means nothing because real is rare, and Michael Bloomberg is not real, especially for women.
Well, you heard it here. I don't have to say another word. That's Zen Sams. Thank you so much for joining us again, as usual. She's always bringing us the best stories on Wednesdays, and we're going to keep our eye on that Weinstein trial. And I will keep pounding the table on Michael Bloomberg's past remarks about women and about minorities and about how he treated his employees and about how he overturned the vote of the people in New York and bought himself a third term. There's an oligarch, folks. We're going to take a quick break. More Liquid Lunch for you right after this.